Us to talk about the health concerns that still remain is Dr. Emily Hyle, an infectious disease specialist at MGH. Dr. Hyle, thank you for being here as always. The predictions are this holiday travel season will be the most normal we've seen in quite a while. What are your concerns about a spike in cases as people return home?
It's a really important question. I think that we could very well see a rise in cases after family gatherings for Thanksgiving. And now is really the time to start planning for that in terms of how can you reduce the risk of any transmissions within a group gathering. This is most important for groups that are going to include people who are unvaccinated, but even for people who are vaccinated and is particularly vulnerable family members there, you can put in a few important measures, such as holding your gathering outside if possible. If you're inside, opening windows or doors to improve ventilation. Staying masked indoors is also very helpful. And then last, in using some kind of testing, either rapid tests or other tests before you gather to ensure that everybody who is gathering is not actively infected at the time.
Good to know there is something you can do. And we've heard again and again that the best protection is vaccination. If someone gets that first dose now, though, how much does that help by Thanksgiving Day?
So I want to be really clear. The best time to get your first dose of the COVID vaccine is now, because the sooner you get that first dose, the sooner your body starts to make the immune protection that protects you against serious disease. With that being said, if you're currently unvaccinated and get a dose today or tomorrow, your body is going to take some time to make that immune response. And so you wouldn't be fully protected by Thanksgiving in particular. So I would still recommend, if you do go get that first dose this weekend, that you continue to act as though you're unvaccinated, meaning particularly wearing masks and testing before you see anybody vulnerable over the Thanksgiving holiday.
Okay, let's talk about boosters. All adults can now roll up their sleeves for that added shot. Should people be trying to get that boost before they gather, and how much added protection would that offer?
That's right. So the CDC approved a booster dose for all adults over 18 in the U.S. yesterday. That means anybody who would like a booster can go and get one. And I think there is real benefit to everybody in terms of reducing symptomatic disease. And that's important because people feel poorly even if they don't have serious disease requiring hospitalization and risking death. With that being said, there are a number of people who are at particularly high risk for serious disease who would really benefit the most from a booster shot. And those include people over 65, as well as people with serious health issues, or even less serious health issues, but anything that would put them at higher risk for COVID. I also want to emphasize that people who had one dose of the J&J vaccine are eligible for a booster after 2 months from that dose, and they are at a particular benefit from getting that booster. So anybody who got a J&J dose, I would also put into that group of having particular benefit from a booster.
Good to remind us of that. And there's no question the cases are climbing again. What are you watching when it comes to those numbers, and how concerned are you about the months ahead?
I think the winter can be challenging in the Boston area. It gets cold and dark, and it's hard to gather outside where we know risks of COVID transmission are lower. So I think we're fortunate this year that we do have a lot of tools that are available to us to reduce the risk of COVID over the winter months, including vaccination for those who are still thinking about vaccination but haven't done it yet. Boosters, as we just discussed, and flu vaccines are going to be very important because we are seeing some flu throughout the U.S. already. So I think with those measures, as well as continuing to mask indoors, we could really reduce the risk of a bad winter. But it is important to do all of those things over the coming months for sure.
Good advice as always. All right, Dr. Emily Hyle, an infectious disease specialist at MGH, thank you so much for joining us this morning.